Ready for medical career growth? Yes, you are in the right place. Hello, this is Dr. Neema Bish, BDS by degree and a pharma professional. As a founder of Career in Pharma, our mission is to guide medical professionals towards remarkable success in the pharma industry. With a track record of over 700 plus students trained and placed into various premier pharma companies, we are here to elevate your journey. Everyone, once again, I welcome you all to Career in Pharma. So today in this video, we are going to discuss about the important interview question for the role of drug safety associate. Now, first of all, before I jump into the important interview questions, I would like to tell you what exactly this role is. So drug safety associate is also known as pharmacovigilance associate or pharmacovigilance executive or a safety associate. Now it is a pharmacovigilance profile and a fresher role into pharmacovigilance. And in few companies, it is also known as safety associate trainee. So all these are the same roles, just the name varies depending on the company. Okay, so let's begin with the important interview question. Now, why today I'm discussing this important interview thing for drug safety associate? Because in the coming few months till February, March 2024, we are going to expect, new openings for freshers as well as experienced. And this I'm repeating from my past 2 to 3 videos. Okay, so you have to be ready to grab this opportunity. Yes, so here we go. So before I tell you the technical questions, I would like to give you a brief how the interview goes. Okay, so first of all, if for any company, when your resume is shortlisted, first step is your resume will be shortlisted. After that, based on your resume, if shortlisted or not, you are going to get a call from recruiter, that is HR of the company. Now here, the first call will be from HR and they will ask you about your few basic details through call, and they will check your flexibility and your timings, and accordingly they will schedule a virtual interview. Now 99% it is virtual interview as of now. Maybe you have to go physically to office also for the same. So whatever it is, either it's virtual or a physical walk-in interview, questions and the way of interview remains the same. Yes. So looking upon your flexibility, recruiters is going to fix the interview, virtual or physical. Now, whenever you are going for any interview, be it virtual or physical, few things you have to keep in mind. Okay. Now, what are these things? First of all, please remember that you can't give all the answers. I mean, if interviewer is asking you 10 questions, then definitely there will be 1 to 2 questions which you will not able to answer. So that is completely fine, completely okay. So don't get nervous. Whatever you are answering, just answer it with full confidence. What you don't know, then you can tell to interviewer that I'm not able to recollect or recall, or sorry, I don't remember it. Likewise, you can say always that you don't know. Okay. Don't give blunders or don't do blunders or don't just fabricate unnecessary answer just to tell something, right? This is very important point. You need to keep it in your mind, because many times what happens, when you don't know the answer and you try to fabricate it, you try to just, put the thing so that at least you answer, then many times you will say something which is not a part of that question or answer, or maybe you are giving more chances to interviewer to ask you more questions. Yes. So don't give unnecessary answers which is not related to the questions. Just be to the point, precise and concise. Okay, if you don't know, then simply say I don't. Other very important thing you have to keep in mind that always feel free to communicate. Feel free to communicate means ready to say no also if you don't know, and always ready to add points, always ready to ask freely if interviewer want you to ask something to them. Please feel free, ready to communicate. This shows that you are a person with good communication. It shows that you are a confident person. Don't be shy. Just open up yourself. Not very much, but yeah, whatever is asked and whatever you want to ask to interviewer, please feel free to do so. Show your confidence, because guys, confidence is very important, and which you can show through your communication, through the way you are going to communicate. Yes, so don't be nervous. Just be confident. Whatever you are answering, just be precise, concise, and with a full confidence present yourself. Yeah, and keep a smile always. Don't be very serious in interview, like, you know, you seriously prepare for something. Okay, don't be like that. Always greet the interviewer before you start, whether it's good morning, good or evening, whatever it is, just greet them. Keep a smile on your face, and please don't be show that you are very serious or, you know, very angry man kind of person. Yeah, so please greet everyone, have a smile on your face, because smile can change anything, right? And other than this, yeah, and please show your flexibility, show your energy in interview. It should not be monotonous, and show that you are an energetic person, flexible person, ready to open, ready to learn new things. All those things you can't say directly, but through your answers, through the way you communicate, will reflect all these things which the interviewer are looking for. Remember one thing, more than what you know, whatever knowledge you are holding, the most important thing is what your attitude is. Because knowledge is something they can give you more and more, right? But attitude is something which no one can change for you. Okay, so show the right attitude in a right direction, and please communicate. Yes, so now we'll begin with the basic technical. Now, before the interviewer jump into technical question, definitely they're going to ask you few common questions. First of all, you need to prepare your brief introduction. Now, in this brief introduction, remember one thing, that this introduction should be less than a minute, or maximum a minute, 1 minute introduction, which should include your name, your qualification, when you completed your graduation, after that what you did and what you are doing currently. That's it. No need to dig into personal things, that I have this family, though this kids, I live here, there, that, though. No. If interviewer is asking, then definitely you have to answer, but in your brief introduction, it should be very limited to the point. Less than a minute brief introduction you can just give. And we have an old video on a brief introduction. You can just check out our old videos also. Now, second question, if you are from a clinical background, and not just clinical background, if you are from, let's say, a core pharmacy background, or maybe if you are from a microbiology background, then next question to you will be definitely why you want to switch. Let's say if you are from a pharmacy background, they will ask you why you want to come to industry from being a core pharmacy background. Let's say if you are a doctor or a dentist or from clinical background, they will ask you why you want to switch to non-clinical background. Or if you are from a microbiology background, then they may ask you why you want to come to pharma industry, which is like totally different. So you have to prepare this answer also very well. Now, one thing, please understand, always be genuine and always give authentic answers. Okay, authentic in the sense, don't try to manipulate the things. Okay, be honest, authentic, and give your answers accordingly. But definitely, to give this answer also, you need to prepare this answer in advance. Prepare doesn't mean you have to fabricate, manipulate. Prepare means to keep your answers in proper words, a beautiful sentence, you need to prepare it. So please prepare this question also, why you want to come to non-clinical field or the field which is not related to you. Regarding the same question also, you can just find our past videos. We have old videos in this also, why you want to change your career path. Now, regarding pharmacovigilance, see, pharmacovigilance topic which they can ask you in interview, these are very limited topics, okay? So, the questions could be, you know, what is pharmacovigilance? What do you understand by pharmacovigilance? What is WHO definition of pharmacovigilance? What is adverse event? What is adverse drug reaction? What is difference between adverse event and adverse drug reaction? What are the different criteria to call any event as a serious adverse event? What is signal? What is signal management, detection? What is risk management? Yes. And what is MedDRA? What all things we can code with the help of MedDRA? What is WHO DD? What all things we can code with the help of WHO DD? How we can code the company drug, MedDRA full form, current version of MedDRA, and also they can give you case scenario examples where maybe they can just give you some case examples and they can tell you that if this is an adverse event simply or a serious adverse event. Or through that case scenario, they may ask you what is the suspect drug in this, what is the suspected event in this. Yes. Different causality assessment scale. What is causality? What is different causality assessment scales? What is WHO UMC causality assessment scales? What is unexpectedness, expectedness, listedness, unlistedness? Okay. Also, what is case processing? Basics about case processing. Yeah. So these are basic things which you should know. Without doubt, without fail, if you are going to give interview for any pharmacovigilance profile, fresher role. Also, you should be knowing a bit about the names of few database which are in use in pharmacovigilance inside industry, and little bit a brief idea about the database also you should be having, like what we do with the database, how we do the data entry, all those things. Okay, so this is about the basics of the pharmacovigilance. Along with this, you need to also prepare little bit from your core area also. Now, core area means, let's say you are from a pharmacy background. So, regarding pharmacology, drugs, mechanism, all those things you should be knowing. If you are from a clinical background, you should be knowing about clinical conditions, their pathology, and mechanism of action of different drugs. Pathophysiology of disease, all these things you should be knowing. If you are from microbiology background, then you should be knowing about the microbiology, the core microbiology, whatever you have learned in your microbiology subjects. Yes, because definitely questions from your core background can be asked without doubt. Other than this, whenever you are going to give interview in any company, whatever the company is, be it CRO, be it BPS, be it co-pharma companies, you should be knowing about that company. So please Google about the company before you give interview. One night before you give interview, please Google. For example, if you are going to give interview about IQVIA, you should be knowing what is IQVIA. Yes, why the name is IQVIA, if it's CRO or the core pharma company, where the headquarters is, which, in what all therapeutic areas IQVIA is. So like that, you should be doing R&D about that company one night before you come for interview. Okay, so this is about the interview questions for pharmacovigilance and from your core area, clinical background, and about the company. And always based on the company's therapeutic area, based on the area in which the company is, the drug in which the company is, accordingly you have to prepare your medicine question also and pharmacology question also. For example, if IQVIA is mainly into oncology product, then you need to know what is cancer, what is benign and malignant tumors, what are different categories, TNM classification, okay, and also different chemotherapeutic agents available, their mechanism of action, the pathophysiology of cancer disease. So like that you have to prepare. So you have to prepare it in a smart way. Okay, smart way means you can't prepare all the medicine pharmacology one night before you give your interview, right? So this is called smart way. Just do the R&D about the company, that is very important, and accordingly other questions will fall in place regarding medicine and pharmacology. So this is about the technical question. And also we will share the link of a PDF which belongs to the important interview questions of pharmacovigilance. So in description of this video you can find important interview question link also. So please download that link and have important interview questions folder as well related to pharmacovigilance. Now when your technical round is over, when all the questions are over, then towards the end of the interview, definitely the interviewer will tell you about the shifts and all those things. Basically why they are telling you, because they are just checking you how much flexible you are to work in any shifts or work in any time. So just answer accordingly and they will check that you are flexible to come to office or not, or you are flexible to work in morning shift or not, or evening shift or not. And little bit about their personal things also they may ask. Let's say if you are married, they may ask you how many kids you have or any kids planning, all those things. So always be clear with all these answers also. Be clear means it should not happen that while giving your answers to the interviewer, you are in a confused state. Means let's say if they ask you, do you have any planning for kids? If no plan, directly say yes, I don't have any plans currently because currently I am just focusing on my career. Okay, so I don't have any plan. Currently I don't have any plan like that. So you should be very clear. वो हम लोग बोलते हैं ना तुम्हारी आपकी energy clear होनी चाहिए. That kind of clear energy should be coming from your answers and from your behavior and through your body gestures and all during your interview. Okay. So yeah, this is all about the technical round of interview. And after that, once you done with the technical round, then HR will again call you and they will just do the C2C negotiation and all those things. Okay. So maybe we will come up with some next video on C2C negotiation also. So this is all about this video where I discuss about the important interview questions for Drug Safety Associate. And don't forget to download the PDF link for the important interview questions of Drug Safety Associate. So guys, I hope you like this video and I hope this video is going to help you a lot in clearing in your interview for Drug Safety Associate and Pharmacovigilance Profile. Okay, with this I'm going to conclude this video. And guys, please, if you really like the content, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and please hit a like if you like this video. And also please don't forget to share this video with your friends or your colleagues who are looking for the same kind of transition. So we'll be coming soon with some fresh next video. Till the time I can again, till that time, please stay safe, healthy, aware, updated, and please keep exploring new things. And please remember one more time, please remember that interview is not just checking how much knowledge you have. Interview will check about your attitude, about your personality, about your communication, and how much confident you are. So please keep these small things in your mind which are very important. Okay guys, with this I'm going to conclude this video and thank you once again.